Hello everybody and welcome to another video in my throwback vlog mini-series. If this is the first video that you're watching from me, I'm doing a little mini-series where I look back on my 2017 Walt Disney World trip and I'm releasing new videos each week of our days at Disney. These videos are going to be a little different than vlogs I have done in the past or that I'm going to do in the future simply because at the time I wasn't vlogging, I was just recording my experience at the parks. So I rarely explain what's going on or give any type of review. So without further ado, here's another video in my Walt Disney World trip from November of 2017.
They are still there, but the Peoplemover is not.
Oh, what happened?
And then they took it out, but like, these around are still there. I think they took out some of it, but like...
What are they gonna do with it?
Well, it hasn't been there forever.
Well, that's all as I know. Out then.
I don't know. Now we're going to...
We're now entering one of the new wonders of our world, Space Mountain. Blast off on a high-speed outer space adventure and careen to the cosmos.
Are the lights on?
I think it's shut down.
Maybe we'll get to see what the lights on.
Oh, paging Mr. Morrow, Mr. Tom Morrow. Please contact Mr. Johnson in the control tower to confirm your flight to the moon.
Mr. Tom Morrow. The lights are on for Space Mountain.
But where do we see it?
Just not hold your horses here. Look, here, here.
Oh, there it is. Wow. It's floating.
By the way, there are two tracks. There were two sides.
Oh. It's just steep.
Is that it? Are we done already?
Huh?
Are we done already?
That was kind of traps in there with the lights on.
It's just like a roller coaster.
Huh?
It's like a roller coaster.
Yeah. Look, there are people waiting for one day.
For a different high-flying adventure, hop on board the Astro Orbiter. Pilot your own spacecraft as you take a spin around the planet and ascend to otherworldly heights. Families welcome you into their homes of yesterday and today, starting way back in the turn of the 20th century.
The Carousel Progress building is still there, but it's not Carousel Progress. It's all Star Wars. They kept the building that they used to have for Carousel Progress,
it's a perfect reminder that this
but it's not there anymore. They put Star Wars stuff in there.
Star Wars?
Yeah, you can meet like Darth Vader.
Instead of the Carousel of Progress.
They got rid of it a long time ago.
What are you talking about?
It's Disneyland! Disneyland!
They did!
And just in case you didn't know, the Carousel of Progress was actually at Disneyland after the World's Fair up until 1973, and that is when it moved to Walt Disney World in Florida. Now back to the video.
Time has stopped the growth and will resume motion at any time.
I'm going backwards yet.
Please be seated for your own safety. Thank you.
I hate when these things happen. Whatever that was.
Sometimes people stand up in these things.
Huh? How can people stand up in it?
Sometimes people stand up in these things and then they have to stop it and they have to say, sit down.
Oh.
Woo! Look!
What's that?
The castle!
This time it's laughter thereafter at Monsters Incorporated. So drop in and join Mike Wazowski and all his pals at Monsters Incorporated
platform.
I lost my bearings here.
So you got to meet Tiara today.
Who?
Tiara.
Yeah, Tina.
Tiana.
Tiana.
I'm a piranha. They're in the Amazon.
They extended this.
I don't think they extended anything. It is so perplexed.
It's been a pleasure to have you aboard.
Here she comes, in the school. Come on. Here she comes, in the school. Turn it off. Mom, what are we waiting for? What are we waiting for? Carousel Progress.
Walt's own idea from beginning to end. He loved it. He introduced the show at the World's Fair in New York City in 1964, and it was an immediate smash hit. May the century begin.
There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow,
shining at the end of every day. There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
Yeah, it looks like the Robins are getting ready to celebrate Valentine's Day today. What year is it? Oh, right around the turn of the century. And believe me, things couldn't be any better than they are today. Oh, that sure beats chopping wood. And isn't our new icebox a beauty? Look at that. Holds 50 pounds of ice. Milk doesn't sour as quick as it used to. And our dog Rover here keeps the water in the drip pan from overflowing.
Electric lights? No more kerosene. No more gas.
Sarah sure gets to the core of the apple. That's our teenage daughter. She's getting ready to go to a Valentine's dance across town on one of those new horseless trolleys.
I think it's very romantic you're taking Mother out for Valentine's dinner this evening.
Well, you know what kind of sport I am.
I only hope I have an evening as romantic.
Just a dream away.
Phew, boy, hottest 4th of July we've had in years. We've come a long way, though, since the turn of the century over 20-some-odd years ago. You know that pilot fella, Charles Lindbergh? He's about to fly a single-wing airplane all the way across the Atlantic. He's never going to make it. Mr. Edison sure added life to our home. Well, there, you'll blow a fuse. Crap, that's the third one this week. I buy fuses by the case.
Every time he has company, he blows a fuse. And guess who always has to change it?
I heard that, young man. I heard that.
Oh, well, that's more like it. John, yours is the last costume I've got to finish before the parade starts.
Sarah's ladies' club is responsible for our town's 4th of July celebration tonight. She's got us all roped into performing in their program,
and I've decided we're going as George and Martha Washington, dear.
Well, it's another Halloween here in the fabulous 40s. Everything is better than ever now, and we've got some amazing new wonders around the house to prove it. For instance, our refrigerator holds more food and ice cubes. And thanks to our automatic dishwasher, I don't have to dry the dishes anymore after supper. Gives Rover and me more time to enjoy our evening stroll together. Later, boy.
Just a dream away.
Isn't it a pleasant holiday? Turkey's in the oven, it's peaceful and quiet.
Yes! 300 points, my best score yet.
Well, it was peaceful until Santa brought that new virtual reality space pilot game.
Temperature to 375.
Look at that, it even talks back.
Reminds me of certain people I know.
Yeah, right, Dad.
975?
John, what's wrong with the oven?
What?
Big Enjoy
the meal. Anyone for pizza?
Don't worry, Dad. Someday, everything's going to be so automated, you won't ever have to cook another Christmas turkey again.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow.